The histogram shows how something is distributed on a scale. It groups data into intervals and you decide where the interval starts and finishes. In this video, I show you how to go from data like this to a cool looking histogram like this. Casper from Spreadsheeter here, and the first thing you need to do is to select the data. And in this case, we have ages and participants for person IDs, for example, from a group of people who participated in something. And we want to track their ages and see how they distribute. So select column B with all the ages. Then for step two, go to insert and hit the histogram over here, right here. Now, basically you're done, right? But for every histogram, you need to modify it so it fits the bin sizes or the interval lower and upper thresholds for this to make any sense. So step number three is obviously to modify this. But before we dive into that, please subscribe to the channel. Thanks. All right, so to change the interval size, just right click on the horizontal axis here and hit format axis. And from here, you can choose the bin sizes, which you can modify right here, bin width, and you can select whatever you need. Let's do 5, hit enter. And now there are plenty of bins with groupings of the ages. So people from 14 to 19 is over here. And you can see that young people in general are overrepresented here in this data set. There are other options for modifying the bin sizes. You can do number of bins instead and say, well, I want 4 bins, and just let Excel do the grouping and the interval sizes. You just say you want 4 bins. You can make overflow bins, like for people over 50. You can make a category for that right here. Also, you can do the same with underflow bins. Those are not the typical actions you want to take, but the most useful ones are the bin width and the number of bins, and that's how you control how your bins or intervals are made. A quick last tip is that if you want this to look better, just go up here in the chart styles and pick any other design than the one that is default, like this one, for example. This looks pretty great, all right? Please watch this video over here to better understand the histogram and what it really tells you. Also, if you want to learn more Excel, please check out my video over here that YouTube thinks is a great fit for you. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Hi, Mom. Yeah, people are totally gonna love this video.